I don't know. It's only natural you get some, you get that song confused. There's so many different versions of it everywhere. All right, so now if we want now to progress in the story, am I literally gonna beat the game tonight? I might actually, like, genuinely, because I'm really on a roll here. All I gotta do is take the magic bus. Actually, I think we gotta talk to the king and queen first. Fuka fuka, yeah. Let's all do the fuka fuka, yeah. This area takes a long time to get around. Oh, this is where Birdo was. Da 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 da. You know, maybe we didn't have to talk to the king and queen. Oh, no, I guess we did. Mom, Dad! We were able to find the star, dear. Yeah, the Axe and Rangers took it away from us, but we got it back again.
That's wonderful. Now the star, star way can be repaired, right? I guess not. You're still missing a piece, I take it.
The last star. Wait, the only place left to look is in Bowser's keep.
Yeah, we know, but there's no way to get in. Believe me, we tried, but...
Yes, yes, even Mario can't jump that far.
Alright, I'll let you use the magic bus! That's it, dear. You should use the magic bus! Sorry, I'm sorry. Tim did that in his LP and it was so funny. The time has come for you
to take the magic bus! Why, when I was your age...
Really? Are you sure it's alright?
Of course, dear. I'll order the repair man to have it fixed by the time you leave.
Come on, Mario, let's go. Yeah, let's go. Let's get out of here. You know what? I don't feel like going that way and falling through that cutscene and climbing back up. I would rather just leave the castle. God, this remake is so good. Oh, such an absolute joy. I mean, even if I get frustrated sometimes because the timing is really awkward, sometimes I feel like the timing is really awkward and I struggle with it. It just kicks so much ass, man. Oh, you know what I just realized? I haven't been back to that guy in Moleville in a while. That guy who sells random crap. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna take the magic bus and then I'll go back and we'll leave Bowser's Keep. The bus has finally been repaired. We can start operating again. I think we can leave Bowser's Keep. Like, I don't think you have to finish Bowser's Keep before you can go back to the world map. I wouldn't be that surprised if you did, though. Man, look at this magic bus, and it's like Mario Party 5 Super Duel Mode ass.
Oh, it's purring like a kitten.
Nice. So let's go! Just jump on! Thank you. With your mashed potato ass. All aboard! Alright. Oh, cool. I don't remember. Oh, you know, I think I do remember this. I love how that looks just as shitty as it did in the original game. So.
Ah, the scent of boiling lava. It's so nice to be home.
Smithy's gonna pay for stealing my splendid castle from me. So, can I travel? I guess so. I wanna go to Moleville quickly before we go on with that. I wanna see if I can buy the frying pan yet. Because this guy sells three things, I think. A mystery egg. Oh, that's right. This is when you get this. Jeez, I should have bought that hours ago. A feather. Eh?
I don't remember that.
Yes, you can get the metal plate. Well, that's a little bit sad. That's actually a little bit sad because that's Peach's ultimate weapon. The frying pan. Man, her attack is high. Oh, no, it's not. Well, Mario's got the attack scarf on, that's why. We got a feather? What, do we have two feathers now? Yeah, we just have two feathers. Okay. Now, the quartz charm, I don't remember what that does, but I think I'm going to give it to Gino. Yeah, what does that actually do? Quartz charm. Okay. Attack and defense plus 50%, and it also protects against instant death. It also protects against Minute Maid instant rice. Alright, cool. Do we have any... Let's spend the rest of our money on fireworks. Because I've never actually, like, bought the fireworks before, but they change the credits. If you buy more fireworks, you get, like, an... It changes the... At the very end of the credits, you get, like, more... The fireworks at the end, they change. Am I gonna look in every single house other than the house that I'm supposed to be looking in? There you are. Jeez. Oh, you ran out of fireworks. Okay, never mind. Jeez. Okay, you know what else I want to do? I want to look at Tadpole Pond. Tadpole Pond songs. A, I want to find out where you learn. You stupid fucking stupid ass polygon. Tell me where to find the song. I know I don't need to, but I don't want to just like, I don't want to not show where you actually get it. Ugh, fuck it, I'll do it later. Two websites in a row that just tell you the sequence of notes and not where to learn it in-game. Like, dude... What are you, a guide for Earthbound Zero? Alright. Oh, you know what? We gotta bring Bowser into the party, because if you have Bowser in the party, a lot of the enemies in here actually, like, don't attack as often. The Forky is enraptured. Whoa! I forgot what weapon I had. Oh, Mr. Bowser! Lord Bowser! Bowser's scaring the terracotta! Ha ha. I'm surprised I didn't change that name. Like, what the hell does terracotta have to do with anything? Everybody dies at the poker! Okay, whatever. I don't particularly want to fight all you fools, but okay. Ow. Man, that's a lot of damage. Sheesh! Oh, Mallow 2. Cool. Let's just get out of here. There's lots of enemies in here. I'm not missing any enemies, am I? Oh, I love this song, man.
Jinx, testing capabilities. Jinx, you asked for it. And Jinx, sensei in action. That's hilarious.
Red all's training, he's not much stronger. But that's no surprise since his strategy is still based around hoping for a lucky hit.
Oh god, I love this music so much. He's nowhere near experienced enough to beat me. I should be okay as long as I use Valor up and occasionally attack twice. This is a bad time for me to start sympathizing with my opponents. I've got Quicksilver and Silver Bullet, and they won't be affecting those. If they let their guard down, they're done for. They'll learn that soon enough. With bombs away after Vigor up, I'm not holding back. I can't lose! He crossed dimensions in order to come here from the world of Last Illusion. Aha. Uh-huh. A story about crystals. Too bad he's still so two-dimensional. Animations! Fun. I feel a bit out of place. A crystal with mastery over fire. It has a burning dissatisfaction with its master, who is trying to turn the fire of justice into a malevolent force. It requires a damp environment to possess the soothing power of water, which supports life. Mastery over earth. After its long slumber deep within the earth, it unleashes amplified tremors all at once as it awakened. The howls of the wind, crossing the world and moving the atmosphere, echo thunderously from it. Simple stuff. It's a please no, they never ever stop watching you. It was caught cheating at treasure chest slots and confined inside the police as a punishment, where it is being forced to clean. Barret because of their absurdly painful bite. Is it strange to call these smile axes when the only time they show their pearly teeth is to bite? Well, no, you can smile with your mouth without your teeth showing. That's what you get from a freak of nature like this. Pretty, though. Grinder is their move where they swipe with their spears instead of using their claws. As they say, the early birdie grinds the worm. That's weird. They're in high demand as shell wax models. Double page spreads only, of course. The glives are off. They want to heal injured orb users, but they're going through a trial separation right now. Will the orb users and orbisons never ever reunite? They're definitely not filler. That's just how monsters are. These big ears are known as the gourmands of the imp world. They love meat dishes, especially hamburgers and hashed beef rice. That sounds really good. Hashed beef rice. Some of them retire and enjoy a second career as shopkeepers. Some of them retire and enjoy a second career in Paper Mario. Even when I think it's no pressure for his powerful ice matter will leave you pale with fear. To understand what they're all about, you need to peek at the thoughts of the person inside, not the suspicious Shelly. The way that she shut herself away inside Shelly may mean that she was patiently pining for the one who'd come break open her shell. Why is there an arrow? Oh, I see. They may bounce like they haven't a care in the world, but if they're hit with an attack, they'll explode immediately. Talk about being excitable. And me, your egg's husband! Oh my god! He imprinted on Valentina when he hatched and thought she was his mother? Oh no! No! He was shocked to discover that he was secretly Prince of Nimbus Land. He resents Valentina, who's not his real parent, and took it out on some of her statues. But ultimately, he can't ignore his debt to her for raising him. Oh, you know what? Hang on, we can get a thought peek here. I'm hungry. I'm still hungry. I should head home already. She knows enough about food to pronounce pizza in the traditional way. What? Her favorite candy is those Valentine's message hearts, chalky as they are. You can't even buy... Can you even buy those anymore? That's really funny. Slap. Bitch. Thanks, Mom. Bitch. She has a lot of magic. She's pretty strong if you don't kill her as quickly as I did. Magma. Since they resemble magmite in shape and color, and because their names start with the same four letters, they often get each other's mail by mistake. They're jealous of... Armored Ant, they're jealous of Shoguns because their names sound a lot cooler. I've seen a whole lot of monsters, but I still have a really hard time telling the difference between lava babbles and lava bubbles. Those who fled from the village of gorillas settled at Barrel Volcano. As time passed, they eventually became known as Chained Kongs. Is it too much of a stretch to guess that the reason they carry water bottles is to fight the heat start caused by the volcano's unbearable temperature? What? Oh, because they have pure water. These urchin-like creatures are thought to live only in the sea, but these live in a sea of magma! They give new meaning to the idea of stomping your feet in frustration. Because they don't touch the ground, they can't stamp along with their feet. It must be a frustrating feeling. Their go-to attack is backfire, but when they're in a tough fight and fly off the handle or fall in love, they get agitated and use va-va-voom instead. Yeah, the bloodstains add a little extra touch of va-va-voom, don't they? Stone statues were built in its image to soothe its temper, but the likeness was way off, so in the end they didn't have much of an effect. It looks like a rock, so you might wonder if it can even be considered a monster. But since you can get a peek at its thoughts, it must be one, right? The character designer's reasoning for giving... The character designer's reasoning for giving it tattered clothing only after it becomes zombified is because it didn't look like a zombie without it. Though he is the de facto leader of the Action Rangers, he's so careless that he often flubs his poses, intro speeches, and group formations. He's cool and composed, but like all the Action Rangers, something about him is a bit pathetic. He got his beloved sunglasses at a dollar store. Always calm and doesn't sweat the small stuff. The other Action Rangers think he's aloof, but he hasn't bothered to notice. Considers himself the looker of the team. He tires easily, but not from being out of shape, but from too much hot yoga. She considers herself the princess of the group. Meeting an actual princess has done nothing to change her mind on this point. Admittedly, its breaker beam attack would be cooler if it was called Absolute Breaker of Champions Beam. But we're not getting paid by the word here. I don't know. Their red color doesn't make them three times as fast. Unlike Jothels, they prefer seafood. They get carried away thinking about raw oyster season. Alrighty. Anyway. Are you guys still called Goo Goombas? They're called Pro Goombas! Well, that's silly. Dang it. Hey, maybe I can win! No, you can't. No, you can't! Scary. Oh, Peach leveled up, huh? Oh my god! Look at all that! Oh my god! Look at all that HP! Jeez! What? Ah, dang it. Where's the crustacean station? Oh, you're so funny. And there's Bowsy. Now, do I remember? Now, ugh, man. This is gonna be a pain. Grand Troopa! And Malakoopa, you totally could have kept calling these guys Tubbo Troopas. Like, Malakoopa is about on the level of Tubbo Troopa. Like, why the name change? What, do we just hate Woolsey? I'm a high-level elite paratroopa. Heart! Bowser's scaring the Malakoopa! Okay. The big guy's ready to launch. I outgrew my old shell a while ago. Okay. Uh-oh. Ow! Oh, that didn't hurt that bad. And there's Gino. So happy, man. Anything new in here? Same old crap. Nope, Thunderbolt. Thunder Carnival! Boom!
Bowser's scaring the Malakoopa! Bowser's scaring the Malakoopa! Ooh!
Ba-dum, 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 ba. Alright. Oh, God, this music.
Ooh, it's scary!
Oh my God, what a mess! Oh man, we're gonna get to fight Boomer at the end of this. That's gonna be cool.
What the fuck was that?